Afternoon, everyone. I know everyone in Ontario here is gearing up for school to go back next week. I don't know if that's what's happening for you, but I hope you have a great long weekend otherwise. So today I wanted to pop on and talk a little bit more about the gut-brain connection. And I'm inspired to talk about it today because I have a client that I'm working with in my Holistic Anxiety Fix, which is my 12-week program to support women to address anxiety so that they can embrace life with calm confidence. And one of the weeks in this program, we actually talk about the gut-brain connection. And what's fascinating is that this particular client had visited to the doctor, and the doctor had said, "What are you talking about? There's no connection between the gut and the brain." And it just sort of blew my mind because she had gone in with anxiety, and she knew intuitively and otherwise that there was a connection between what was going on in her gut and what was happening with her experiences of anxiety. And that is exactly how I understand anxiety as well, because I think anxiety is a symptom that something is off, and sometimes it can be various different things, and one of the things that it can be is your gut. So I talk to a lot of women who share with me that they have gut issues, whether it's GERD or acid reflux. Some women have had their gallbladder out. Some women have IBS, so they're either constipated or they are alternating between constipation and diarrhea. It can really change between the person. For some people, they eat foods and they feel terrible. So maybe if you're listening to this, you have this sense of like, oh yeah, like I do have gut issues. And so what I want to do today is I want to really connect your gut issues to your symptoms of anxiety. And this was actually the case for me. So not the whole piece of my anxiety puzzle, but a chunk of it was actually linked to some of the infections that I had in my gut. One of them being a giant worm. So you can imagine that that worm would have absolutely have triggered my anxiety, right? So let's talk about different ways that our gut can be connected to anxiety. So the first thing that I tend to see is actually if you're eating very inflammatory foods for your body, and the main one is gluten. So I have an incredible story actually of a woman who took gluten out of her diet because we realized that gluten was something her body was reacting to. And literally within just a couple of days, her entire nervous system calmed down. So that was a really big game changer for her. The other link can be if you have bacterial imbalances or bacterial infections. And one of the infections, which I've talked about in a past life, but I just want to remind you again, in case you're new to these videos, is a Clostridium overgrowth. So if the unhealthy bacteria associated with Clostridium, so the pathogenic type of bacteria, if they overgrow, then it actually prevents your dopamine from breaking down. And then as a result, you're stuck in this excitatory state. And so this can also trigger anxiety for a lot of people. Now, what's interesting is a lot of people think gut to brain, which of course is true, but not a lot of people think brain to gut. And actually, this is also a pretty incredible connection as well. And so this is something that I dove into, and I get a lot of the information, if you're looking for more, from Dadis Kerizian, and he wrote the book, Why Is My Brain Not Working? And essentially what can happen is that if you've had chronic gut issues, if you've been in a car accident, or if you've had any sort of stress or trauma to your body, sometimes the vagal nerve can stop working because the brain stops signaling it. And the vagal nerve is actually responsible for calming our system down and allowing us to properly digest. So there you see the connection right away. If the vagal nerve's not working, guess what? Your system's not calm and you're going to have gut issues. So sometimes it can be linked directly from that vagal nerve activity just not being stimulated. And one of the ways that I often recommend people test for this is that they actually test their gag reflex, which sounds super crazy, but back in the back of your throat, if you engage your gag reflex, it actually will activate your vagal nerve, which is super fascinating. So in my healing journey, one of the things that I did is I gargled hardcore, like loud gargling, for about 3 times a day, just to make sure that I was activating my vagal nerve. And actually, I've had feedback that other clients have done this in the midst of a panic attack and found that it's really helped as well. So hopefully that's provided you with a little bit more insight in the link between the brain to our gut and the gut to our brain, and the importance of connecting them together and addressing both the brain and gut health when we're thinking about anxiety. So I've included here a link to the leaky gut quiz. So if you're wondering, hey, is my gut part of my anxiety? I recommend that you just write quiz below and I will personally message you the leaky gut quiz. Otherwise, I will see you guys next week. Have a lovely weekend.